So it's very much being applied to retailers. So landlords count as creditors. So you may have a retailer with, say, 100 stores, and the retailer will negotiate with the landlords and say, okay, well, if you've got a profitable store, we want to stay in occupation, please. If we've got a store we no longer want to keep because it's unprofitable, then we want to vacate. And then in the middle, you've got a negotiation. So the landlord may offer rent reductions of 20 or 30 or 40% to the retailer and move forward. It is a bit unfair on the landlords because they essentially count with a voting right of £1, even though they have a huge exposure to that occupier. Administration, they may carry on trading if they can trade positively and pay their rent. But essentially, it doesn't really matter which store you are exposed to. All of the stores remain open, or all of the stores will shut. With a CBA, that's different. So that basically has been broken. So now, for the landlord, they have to understand which of their stores the retailers are trading profitably and which of the stores the retailers are not trading. And given that actually they may have absolutely no idea, they may not be given access to the amount of revenue that they're making from each store, is actually very difficult for the investor because it's an asymmetry of information. The retailer knows more than the landlord. So when it comes to cash flow modelling, you need to know more than you did before. Before, you just looked at the covenant strength of the actual occupier. Now, you have to look at not just the covenant strength of the occupier, but the trading in each of the units. You also need to then make an estimate for how much of a rent reduction there is going to be in the event of a CBA. So what's the probability of a CBA, and then what's the outcome of that CBA? So you might say, well, I could assume a third of the time that there'll be a 20% reduction, a third 40%, and maybe a third 60%. But without a lot of information on how the retailer is trading, it's very hard to make those assumptions. It's also hard to understand what the impact is going to be on the market rent. And the market rent is the rent you're going to assume you're going to achieve on a reletting to another occupier. So if you've agreed a big rent reduction on your unit in the case of a CBA, is it then reasonable to keep the old market rent? Or should you be marking it down to the rent reduction that you've had to offer? It's also hard to understand what the impact is going to be on the market rent. And the market rent is the rent you're going to assume you're going to achieve on a reletting to another occupier. So if you've agreed a big